Mitch, you're on mute.
I'm not muted. Can you hear me now? Marie?
Yes, I can. Thank you.
Oh, there we go. Okay. Cooking with gas. Here we go. So thank you all for being here today to celebrate the person of the day, the person of the hour, and how fitting it is that it is St. Patrick's Day and his Irish heritage. So let's give a great SMCCD welcome to our friend and colleague, the Thomas John Bauer, the first of his name. Come on in, Tom. By the way, yeah, I assume it's the first of his name. I don't know. There may be other Thomas John Bauers running around. Who knows? Thank you all for being here. We have some folks joining us virtually, a very, very, very important person. You'll see the name on the screen there, Nilo Ventura. Tom's very, 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 very patient husband is with us. So Nilo, hi. And we have Marie Billy, our interim chief human resource officer as well. And there are maybe others who join us throughout the morning. So that is great. So what we wanna do is, first of all, we wanna lay some ground rules. We're gonna have some folks who are gonna say some things. It is important for us to remember that I know that some of you are here just to confirm that Tom indeed is retiring. not unlike going to funerals to make sure that they're actually dead. But this actually is not a funeral today. So please do not eulogize Tom as if he is going to be going into the ground this afternoon. We'll have time for that at some other point in time. We have lots of great things to say about Tom. And his work with us today. So we've got a number of speakers who are going to be talking to you. But just a couple of quick things first. So yesterday I asked Beth to send out a link to everyone saying, hey, what's that one word that you would use to describe Tom Bauer? And sort of here's sort of the top 10 list of things that sort of came back in no particular order. Quaffed. Wine snob. We use that as a hyphenated word because some people can't follow directions with one word, they use two. Party host, again, hyphenated word. Rosé, part of the wine snob thing. Pork chop. He does love him a pork chop down at Neil's breakfast and the eggs. Medium rare. If you've ever had lunch or dinner with Tom, whatever he's on, has on his plate is still mooing, if you've noticed that. Evidenced by today, Tom, if you'll come over here real quick.
I'm a little nervous. Over
here, right here, so everyone can see.
Right here.
Flip-flops.
You spend this much money, Manny and Pettying, you wear.
Well, so speaking of that, the next one was nails. So there we go. Eyebrows. And of course, the most important thing, pugs. Pugs. So that's what everyone thinks of Tom, or so we think they think of Tom. And that sort of gives a sense of a lot of things about Tom. And there are going to be some folks who are going to talk about more things about Tom. And the first person I want to ask to come up is Beth Dominick. So Mike Clare, our chancellor, is going to say some words at the end of the program. And on paper, Tom reports to Mike, but Beth is the boss. So Beth, where are you? Oh, and by the way, everyone got 2 minutes, and I have a timer over there, too, so guess what?
Oh, that's so much pressure, Mitch.
Go.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you all for being here. I've worked as Tom's assistant now for almost 4 years, and even though that's not long compared to how many years he's been at the district, I feel like I've really gotten to know him. First of all, he is a very funny person and made me laugh every single day. Second, he is a very patient and kind boss. Those very few times when I messed up, he never once berated me, gave me an iota of criticism, or even a frown. The most I would get is raised eyebrows and a look of horror on his face at what I'd done. And then that would make me laugh. So even when times were bad, they were still good. Last and most importantly, he's a very caring person. These last 2 years, I got to see how much energy he really has as he jumped into action to assist those who needed help the most. In April 2020, he and Adolfo started the food distribution at CSM, which eventually expanded to Skyline, and have now served over 120,000 hungry families and community members to date. When I joined them, I saw firsthand how much he cared about the clients and how much they loved him. Tom being there was an event in and of itself. I think he even had his own fan club. He did. He made it a priority to be out there practically every Friday for a year and a half. Every week, he and John would lug out all the supply bins and cases of water, struggle with the tents, maneuver the food boxes, get burned in the sun, freeze in the rain, and then he would greet each car personally with a smile and a warm welcome. For some of the regular clients who are really struggling, I know he assisted them personally out of his own pocket. Also during the pandemic, he and Jamila created the Basic Needs Task Force, and I was fortunate to assist him with that as well. It was incredible to see how much he could accomplish in so short a time, bringing together a variety of people from across the district to help students who needed the basic necessities of housing, food, and mental health support. He truly cares about the students, his staff, and the people he works with, and has made the district a better place. Tom, we all wish you the best of luck and we'll miss you tremendously.
This is real. It smells fabulous.
She's from Hawaii. Of course it's real. You think she'd give you a fake one?
Where did you get this?
She brought it all the way from Hawaii, just for you. Yeah. And Beth, I'm sure that when you did something wrong, it was because Tom gave you the wrong instructions. So just want to make sure we're all clear on that. So now I want to ask the person who's actually responsible for Tom coming to the district, and that may be a good thing or a bad thing depending on what camp you're sitting in. But Kathy Blackwood hired Tom to come to the district some 17 years ago. So, Kathy, come explain yourself, woman.
Well, good morning, all. When I came to the district a year before Tom came, the bookstore was in the middle of a big RFP, whether Barnes & Noble or Follett, or the own bookstore managers would continue the operations of the bookstore. And the committee chose to have our own bookstore managers do it, but we needed a manager to coordinate all three programs. So as we did then, I was not being the hiring manager, I was not on the committee. Instead, we put Jim Keller on the committee. And after they'd done their interviews, Jim came to me and said, we have the perfect person for you. And I interviewed Tom and said, he's right. Absolutely. That's what we're going to do. And at the time, it was to bring all three bookstores together and coordinate their organization, their purchasing, and staffing even. Well, pretty soon he had the cafeterias, and then I think community ed, and then the fitness centers, and then somewhere in there he brought in the coffee shops and the copy shops. And we found out that Tom could organize and work incredibly well at all of these different things. But even more importantly, wherever Tom is, there's family. And, you know, I've got 2 minutes, which is not much. So I just want to say thank you for letting me be part of your family, because you create that with all of your employees, with all of your coworkers, and even your bosses. And that family is incredibly important and a part of your success. And so thank you.
And speaking of that family, one of the longest serving, most respected, generally pleasant folks who work in the district. If you don't like the next two speakers, then you don't like anybody. And the first one of those is the great, great, great bookstore manager from Kenyatta College, Jake Marr.
I think I'll take off my mask just for a moment.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. It is an honor and a privilege for me to speak at Tom's retirement. Although it's a bittersweet goodbye to our amazing boss who has given 17 great years to the bookstores. From day one, Tom made us feel like part of the team. You know, we had barbecues at the Vista, holiday celebration at your home, just stopping by the bookstore to have lunch. In short, I'm saying the consistent theme was food. Tom, with your leadership, the bookstores move forward in many directions. We were recognized and awarded with 2 above and beyond awards by the San Mateo District Board. The bookstores received a national award for innovation. And with your guidance, the first community college president was featured on a national publication. As our roles and duties expanded, bookstore employees always knew that your door was open for us. You were there for us whenever we needed you, your guidance and your support, or just someone to talk to. You supported us during our lows with an open arm and lifted us up. And you encouraged us to do better as a team, but individually and as a group. You guided the bookstore team with open communication, shared ideas with clear goals. Every member of your team has a voice, and success defined by the willingness for each member to work at a betterment by themselves and as for the student body. Tom created an environment where student success was paramount and our input was valued. Under Tom's leadership, the bookstores became an entity focused on finding solutions to the challenges our students faced. The textbook rental program and brown bag lunches are wonderful examples of this. It is no coincidence that both happened under your leadership. Last but not the least, I would like to extend best wishes on your next phase of life. No matter where you go, we will always be praying and cheering for you. I forever will remain grateful to you for what you've given me, the opportunity to be a part of your team and sharing a valuable experience. Even though you will be gone, we expect updates from you, perhaps on Facebook.
I never use Facebook.
That's
I don't know if you all are watching. So from my vantage point, I see Nilo Ventura on my screen, Tom's husband. And as everyone continues to say their version of revisionist history, Nilo keeps wondering, like, who the hell are they talking about? This can't possibly be my husband. So to continue the lies, Jonathan Bissell, come on up.
And Mitch, thanks for giving me permission to talk for 45 minutes. I really appreciate that. It took a lot to think about what to say today, but let me start with what I'm not going to tell you about. I'm not going to talk about what an amazing visionary Tom is and the potential that he sees in our community and how when he hired me, he said, Jonathan, there's so many working parents in our community that they look at the summer camp that we have and it's a half day program. They have to work all day. It just doesn't work for them. There's so many foster youth in our community that don't have any opportunity to get ahead. And I'm not going to talk about that vision that he had to make a difference and to serve hundreds and hundreds of children in our community. And I'm not going to talk about just how willing Tom is to champion things that are unpopular at different times and how there was this need for this internal intensive English program. And under Tom's leadership, it came to life and it met with a lot of opposition, a lot of bitter opposition. And now it's accepted and respected and recognized for the pipeline that it is. I'm not going to talk about that. And I'm not going to talk at all about his incredible leadership and just what a visionary Tom Bauer is and his philosophy of what, not how, where he says, here's this idea that I have. And when he had a really big idea, he'd be like, I want to come into your office. I want to look you in the eyes and see your reaction to this. He'd love to do that.
Yeah.
But he never said, this is how I want you to do it. He just said, run with this. And that was a beautiful thing. And Tom was always amazing with public recognition to say, hey, these people on the team did this. I want to publicly acknowledge them. And if there's an issue, I want to privately talk to you. And when there's challenges, he was there as a support and as a buffer in incredible ways. I'm not going to talk about that. And I'm definitely not going to talk about Tom's ability to rally people for good, as was mentioned earlier by Beth, just the way that he came around for the whole community with the food drive and going back even farther with scholarships for foster youth and students in need that came to our summer camp and other things, and how with the CASA program in San Mateo County, he just rallied countless people to serve. Not going to talk about that at all. Here's what I want to talk about. There's three words. Empathy. You know, it was during summer camp when we tried it out at Kenyatta a bunch of years ago. I was in a meeting with Yuri and I think there was someone from Japan visiting, and I got the call that my mom had just died. And Tom had told me weeks earlier when she was, you know, really not, she was going downhill quickly, and he said, just go, whatever you need to do, just go. And when she did pass, just the empathy that he came alongside me with was incredible. I want to talk about that. And Tom's compassion. You know, I watched as he, as a CASA, as an advocate, he came alongside this young man, John. And so many times he would go to Karma and just advocate and fight for him. And fight for him to be in the right place and to get the right things that he needed, the supports, and fight with John to do homework and countless conversations. I'll call you right back, Jonathan. I'm working with John on the homework, and just the compassion that he had and the potential that he saw of what John's future could be like. And then the compassion to say, I want you to be my son. And that empathy and compassion really leads to the creation of family. And Kathy said it before me, but it really, this is the final word. What it all comes down to is that, Tom, you create family and flourishing wherever you go, and you're going to continue to do that. That Florida culture is going to be different because Tom Bauer is there. So that's what I want to talk about today. Just what an incredible person you are and the family that you create around you. So thank you for everything.
Who knew that not talking about something would take 5 minutes? Let me ask someone who worked with Tom for almost the entire time that he was here to come up. They worked very closely together. She probably knows more secrets, where more bodies are buried, more dirt. And everything she's going to tell you actually is true. So Jenny Brooks, you have something you want to say about Tom Bauer?
Really does know everything.
I'm not going to tell everything. I'm going to talk about personal friendship with Tom. We started at the district around the same time, and over time grew a very treasured friendship. And I was able to share in some really major events of your life. Your wedding with Nilo. Hi, Nilo. Nice to see you. Your adoption of John, who's turned into the most wonderful young man. And you were able to share in my daughter's wedding when you and Nilo attended. And I'm gonna make this really short. I just wanna say something about Tom's heart. His heart has infinite capacity to grow and expand. And he can accept new people in without diminishing anyone who's already there. And I love that about you. And I will always treasure our friendship.
No secrets, that's good.
And I can say absolutely nothing snide, snarky, or rude about what Jenny just said because she knows all of my secrets too. Lessons we learn. Now I'd like to ask a wonderful, wonderful human being, a wonderful public servant, a wonderful friend and former colleague of ours, and just a generally kind and warm person, our former board president over a number of occasions, and now trustee emerita of the San Mateo County Community College District, the incomparable Kyron Swartz.
Yeah. Good, the mask is off.
Yeah, mask on.
I can see your face.
Pretend I'm in Florida, I guess.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you for that rounding world of applause. I don't know that everybody knows me because I've been gone for a year and a half, but reputations, I guess, stick around. One of my former colleagues used to refer to me as, he said, you and I have complete different personalities and lifestyle. And I said, you know what we have? Philosophies. That's what it was. He said, you and I have different philosophies on everything. I said, it's not that we have different philosophies. It's how we treat everybody. I'm trying to be a friendly person. And so I would put it out there that I would talk to anybody and try to help along the way within the district. And I'm so proud that I ended up with a lot of friends. One of them is this guy right here. Such a good friend that I was not too long ago just hospitalized with some very serious issues. And I snuck him in and said he was my son. Because of COVID, you cannot have anybody come visit you. And so here comes my son. My other son had just left, so I don't know. They must think I have a huge family. I offered and wasn't accepted, but I wanted to dance with him at him and Nilo's wedding, because both of them had lost their mothers. But they did without me, but I was there as a guest and loved every minute of it. So on a personal level, I was so happy to establish that friendship with Tom. I am so proud as a former trustee. I was honored to be at events to hear Tom do a presentation about what he had brought to the bookstore. One of my things when I came on the board, and I'm probably one of the oldest ones here who's been around the longest other than Mike Clare.
You said the timer Got plenty of time.
When Tom came, the issue at the bookstore, which I understand might be the same issue today, was that it was desperately losing money. But one of my personal issues was it was so hard for students to afford these darn books. It was awful. And here, so when the hiring committee, headed by Kathy and a bunch of wonderful people, hired Tom, he brought in this program of rental of school of the books, which was a great service to the students, and it was really great. I don't even think that's probably around anymore. Things have changed over the years. But I would go to events, and Tom did presentations. I saw people come up that wanted to steal him away from other districts when he talked about that program, when he talked about what he had done with the athletic center over there, how we were having expanded it to the community, and we were able to raise money. I was sitting at events where he gave huge checks to the foundation for the money that he had been able to put together over money, I guess, when it was extra money, that could go always for students within this district, always being a proud trustee. So I can't say enough about Tom. He's a wonderful person. My husband noticed on Facebook, he's already made so many friends in Florida. Wherever he goes, he makes friends. He does, they just come to him. That's his kind of personality he has. So the word that I put in, which wasn't used, was caring, because he cares so much for other people. It's just he's just a magnet for people to care for him. Nothing but the best for you, my friend. We will keep in touch. It's a good excuse now for us to get to Florida.
Yes.
I've never been beyond the airport there, so I'm very excited to see what else is there. I will not come when the mosquitoes are flying and the alligators are running around. But it was a privilege to and an honor to work with Tom over these years. He was an attribute for this district. There's so many programs that he was given that he's made it work, and they were tough. But he got, you know, how can we make things work was his attitude, and it really paid off. So thank you for all that. It was great. You will be remembered for a long time for all of the things that you've established in this district, whether you want it or not. People will talk about you, and it will be good. I have to say, talking about Jenny, if I ever wanted to find anything out about the district, I would go to Tom, because he seemed to know everything. How that happened, I'll never know.
Yeah, I've had a lot of conversations.
Smile for Gina.
And Tom, I've talked to Karen and Frank both. Don't be mistaken. They let you in as their son to the hospital, but you're not in the will. So I know. Be clear about that. While some of us may have wanted to, some of us have tried, the next speaker is actually the only person in the district who actually fired Tom. So Chancellor Claire, you want to come on up?
But I guess he can't do that now, can he? Too late.
I'm not quite sure what you mean. So can someone tell Mitch Bailey that this is not a roast today? He kind of wants to make this a roast. But Tom, you know, it's been the difficult thing. It's a blessing and a curse to go last. The blessing is you get to, you know, hear what others have to say, but that's also a curse because a lot of what I wanted to say has been said. But it's also affirming because, you know, we all form our own opinions, our own experiences with people. And when I heard a lot of the words, a lot of the, you know, just the accolades, like, yep, that's Tom. So what I want to do, I'll take this thing off too. Yeah. What I want to do is, you know, I think a lot about leadership. And so, Tom, first of all, you're a leader. It's very clear you're a leader. But I want to share three thoughts with you that kind of encapsulate, I think, a lot of what's been said. Long time ago when I was in the private sector, I worked for a person, a client of mine, I really had a lot of respect for, and I won't give you the whole story, but he was in an intense phone call with somebody. It was not a pleasant phone call. I just happened to be in the office, and he kind of put the phone down. And he goes, Mike, there are two kinds of people in an organization, people that create problems and people that solve problems. Always be a problem solver. Is Tom a problem solver?
Yeah.
Yeah. And, you know, Karen, a number of us, every time a new opportunity came up, who's going to do that? Oh, Tom can pull this off. So I know that, you know, you have to work, you have to be careful when you sign on to this district. You got to read the other duties as assigned clause very carefully. And Tom has taken on so many other duties as assigned. And for example, and I can tell you that at the height of, or just when we were starting the pandemic, we really did have to get food to people. I'm like, how are we going to do this? How? I have no idea. My first pandemic. I have no clue. Tom will figure it out. And you did. And of course, in Tom's own way, not only did he figure it out, pretty soon we had semi-trucks rolling up and delivering food and to thousands and thousands of families. So that's just one of several examples. But Tom is a problem solver. The other thing, when I think about leadership, and I say this a lot, and I think about it a lot, it's important to do the work while you're in the seat. That's really important. But to me, the true measure of leadership is, how's the place after you've left? And Tom, when I think about all the work you've done, whether it's the bookstores, food services, auxiliary services in general, we could go right down the list. The mark of leadership is how these places function after you leave. And I know we're under some financial challenges. I get that. I understand it. But it's solvable, because what you've done is you've created an organization. You've created a culture. You've created a way of doing things that'll endure. And that's because of your leadership. And I have a ton of respect for you for that. It's very important that when you're in these roles, that you leave the place better than you found it. And Tom, you've definitely left everything that you've worked with better than you found it. And the final thing I want to do, it was so great seeing the pictures, and you know, and when I, if you saw the slideshow, and I thought of the word family too, right? And that's so important to me. I think that out of all the measures that you know, you think about as a leader, it's, did you create a sense of family? And we've heard it over and over again. And you can't create a sense of family without love. I'm gonna get a little bit, you know, I don't know, verklempt, as they said in Saturday Night Live. But Tom, look at all the people in this room. And there's a lot more that would come if they could get away from where. I know it. We all know it. We know that. You have created a sense and contributed to a sense of family. You are loved. You are. But the reason you're loved, and we've heard it already, is because you've so freely given that love to others. And that's the thing, more than anything else, that stands out to me and your tenure here as a leader. I will never forget you. It's been an honor to work with you. We used to have arm wrestling matches over whether what we were going to do with the cafeteria while CSM was torn down. The part where I knew Tom was the guy, I knew it before. I'll just tell this one story. You've heard it like 10 times now, but building 10 at CSM had just opened. And when I was president of CSM, my wife used to say, you know, CSM's your fourth kid. Or she'd say, you're seeing someone else, and her initials are CSM. That's what she used to joke, because I loved that place. It was my family was most important, don't get me wrong, but that was right there. We got a flood. I rush up there. I left a family. I forget what it was. And who was there? Tom beat me there. And he was supposed to be flying to the Philippines. He dropped I know you made your flight, but I was, Tom, get out of here. You got a flight to catch. And I go, this guy is wired this way. He cares so much. And that's one of several stories I could tell. But again, I can't emphasize enough. You are loved. I love you, my friend. And I know everybody in this room does. And this is just a small token, but we have just a little award, and we're gonna have you talk. Yeah, okay, you get nice to hold it. You're not gonna hit me over the head with it, are you?
Yeah. I can't believe this.
Yeah.
Over the head in front of all these people.
So can we have another round of applause for Tom, and then I think he's going to say a few things too.
You certainly will. And Tom, on behalf of your cabinet colleagues, some of them who couldn't be here today, we have something for you as well, and they've asked that I read this for you. It is a bittersweet moment for us as you leave the district for a new adventure in retirement. We will miss your kindness, sense of humor, and collegiality.
the district is a better place because you are a leader, champion, and mentor. And our chancellor's cabinet is better because you are our colleague and friend. So please accept a small token of appreciation and congratulations. Don't put it all in one place. And we send you our very best wishes in your retirement. Michael, would you put up the other slide that I sent you this morning? So when I started out the conversation this morning, and by the way, Mike Clare could also fire me, and I suspect that may happen this afternoon. But I started out with my top 10 list of those.
I'm really a nice guy, y'all. I'm not firing anybody.
He's not. I say that because he's the only. That wasn't the music. So I started out with my top 10 list this morning, and the list that I gave you this morning was one that I made up last night as I was sitting thinking about how I was going to do this emceeing today. But your feedback from the survey from yesterday is telling, and I put it all into a word cloud, and it is very clear about the affection and regard in which all of us in this district hold Tom. Tom has invited us to be part of his family. His personal family. He's invited us into his home. He's invited us to share the expansion of his family with the adoption of his son, his work with CASA. Some of you were invited to his wedding. Everyone knows everything about Tom because Tom invites folks to be part of his life. And there are lots of folks in this world who don't do that. Today is a very special day for a number of reasons. We're able to celebrate Tom, and it's important that we do that. But I just have to say that it's also wonderful that we just have this opportunity to get together. We haven't had this chance. I mean, we needed this boost in the arm, so thank you for coming back from Florida. We needed this as a whole. There are some folks who couldn't be with us today. Certainly some of Tom's family couldn't join us this day. But you see on the slide there, you know, caring, kind, gift, all those wonderful things are things that talk about Tom. If you'll take that back down, Michael, I want to be able to see Nilo as well. Some folks couldn't be with us today, a very important part of Tom's life and a number of our lives here at the district office, and his wonderful family, his widow and sister-in-law, Sandy and Susan are here, but Tom Moore would have loved being here today with us. We always said in the chancellor's office that Tom was the soul of the district. We have said that Karen Swores was the spirit of our district. And I think we can say that Tom Bauer is the heart of our district. He has opened his heart to all of us. He has made us part of his family. He has done wonderful things for all of us. But at the end of the day, it's always been for students. He's never lost track of the mission, the goal, the prize, and that is helping folks. And you've heard story after story after story today. And there are many, 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 many more. And we joke and kid, and I joke and kid, because we do that to folks who we're comfortable with and who we love and appreciate. Tom was the chair of my search committee. So one of the key reasons that I'm here is, literally one of the key reasons I'm here is because Tom Bauer. He saw something from some, you know, idiot he was seeing on screen from Ohio, like, what the heck is this person doing? But he, you know, he took a chance, and he takes chances, and he supports folks. And he has been a mentor and a friend to so many throughout the district. And I don't want to miss, you know, if we had a pride parade in the district, Tom Bauer would be our grand marshal. And I say this not in the context of what you think. It's because of the support he has given to so many of our LGBTQIA students, faculty, and staff, myself included. Because one of those things you learn in life, when things get a lot easier, is when you accept who you are. And Tom Bauer has helped a lot of folks do just that. And on a whole host of fronts. So to our Grand Marshal, to our district heart, Tom Bauer, I want to ask everyone, please raise your glass and let us toast and thank Tom Bauer as he goes into retirement. And I guess I'm the only one. So I did. I prepared. I don't know what the rest of you were doing.
Somebody brought me alcohol.
Yeah. Yeah, so Tom, come on up, buddy.
All right, so the goal is to try and make me cry. I see. I see how that all goes. Well, I'm tougher than that. Anyway, I'm so happy that everybody is here. Thank you guys all for coming. This is, I didn't plan
that I was going to retire at the time I am, but, you know, hearkening back to something that Mitch said, there's a, Tom Moore is probably one of, if not the closest friend that I will have ever had. And I'll never forget, he was sitting, we were on a call, actually. We used to, during COVID, we would do Zoom calls with Ginny and me and Mitch and Tom. And we did that every single week because, you know, Tom was battling pancreatic cancer and we were all locked up and it was just really depressing. And I'll never forget one of the days, and, you know, it wasn't a particularly great time for me and some other stuff. And Tom just said to me, he goes, you need to do what's best for you and for your family. And he said, when you do that, that's all that really matters. So, you know, after a lot of decision-making and whatnot, yeah, what I've done now in retiring at the time I am is best for me and for my family. Being here for 17 years, has literally been, and just by looking at you guys in this room, has literally changed every single part of my life. Every single part. I mean, when you think, I think back to 2005 when I walked through the door for the first time and they sent me to my office. I left Claremont Colleges and I had this big palatial office with views and everything else. And they bring me to a trailer at Skyline that had a bag over a hole in the wall to catch the rain. And they said, here you go. And I remember getting here and I said, well, I'm off to an auspicious beginning. But honestly and truly, and I know you've all mentioned families. For me, it is when I came to California, I came here alone. My whole family was back in the East Coast. I literally started from nothing. And so it was always very important to me that the work that I do and the time that I spend with people, if they're not family, then it's drudgery. I mean, you come to a place every day and if you can't build that, then it's just such a hard place to go. So I have been singularly blessed that I've had so many people that I've been able to work with that actually want to be part of my family. And I tell people, I was at something last night and, you know, with my old neighborhood, and they were like, you know, you've already replaced us. You have new friends. And I, because they see the pictures on Facebook, you know, like Frank, they saw Florida and yes, we do have new friends, but every place, like I never leave and nobody gets left behind. I mean, you come along and, you know, the great thing about the world that we're in now with Facebook and everything else is that we all get to continue to be connected. But I listen to people talk about the rental program and the great things we've done. Everything that I've been able to work on has not been accomplished by me. It's been accomplished by them. You know, the rental program, the brown bag lunch, Kenyatta College, Jake Kumar, Brian Harwitz, Laura Bridget, that was them. You know, the food distribution, that was Adolfo Leyva. And Adolfo was so passionate about getting this thing done. And he just needed somebody on the inside with grease to make it happen. And, you know, I generally will go wherever nobody else will go. So I was the guy with grease to make it happen. But you know, everything that I've heard up here today, and I thank everyone for all the kind words and the accolades, but it's really all been because other people in my life, other people in my organization, other people on this team make it happen, you know, and I'm looking up at Rick McMahon from Pacific Dining. Now, again, it's very, very, if you go to any college across the United States, right, and you look at food service and it's contracted food service, you don't even know who those people are most of the time. You know, when Rick joined our district and I used to be a, you know, a contract employee, and I said, no, I said, I want all of your staff to feel like they are part of this district. And, you know, I think we had one board member that thought that that was insulting, as I recall, that they would actually work for us. But no, I wanted him and his team to feel like they actually belonged here. So Rick and his team have done such an incredible job transitioning the food services here. I mean, we have freaking first class food service here. We are the bar mitzvah capital of the peninsula, for Christ's sakes, you know, and that is all because of the work that they do to make this place so amazing. You know, Jonathan says all of these wonderful things about me. There is nobody more innovative than Jonathan Bissell on the planet. I don't care who you meet or where you go. I mean, and yes, he's right. I would say, I want you to do this. But yeah, he was right. I never told him how, because I didn't know how. I didn't know how to do it, but he did, and he would always find a way to do it. San Mateo Athletic Club, I mean, I'm not going to speak about that, but that has been one of the singular biggest accomplishments that I've had in this district, is to be able to do that. And I like to joke that I joined this district during what I call the golden age, where, you know, you could be innovative and as crazy as you wanted to be, and those ideas were encouraged and rewarded and recognized. And I was so, so very lucky to come here right when that was happening. So, you know, creating SMAC and all of the people is wonderful. You know, but the bookstores is where I started, you know, and I came here and that was my first family in the district. It still is, and they always will be. And I hear Jay talking about stuff that I've done and what it is all them. I am good at cheerleading people. I am good at knocking obstacles out of people's way. Cause I think we do that too often. We put obstacles up and I'm kind of the guy who knocks them down, but these are the folks that do it. So I'm very, very proud of everybody that's worked with me. You have all made me look better. So, you know, and I could not have imagined having, when I showed up here in 2005, I would never have guessed that we would have been able to do and accomplish the things that we did and accomplished. But I also never would have guessed that I'd be leaving this place with people that I've become so incredibly close to that are like my family. And I'm looking at some of them now that will be a part of my life until the end of my life. And to be able to leave a place and know that is a pretty amazing thing. And the last thing I'll say to the young kids in the room is coming to work every day, I would say 99% of the times I loved coming to work every day. I loved seeing people, I loved hanging out. And I do think this is so great that everybody's here today. And it's like kind of the, when I was out last night and they were like, oh, we're all back together again. And it was just, this is really heartening to see this. And you know, we haven't worn masks in Florida since I got there. So I, you know, kind of like it this way. But it is good to see everybody here together. But to the young people in the room, starting your careers or whatever else, I will tell you, to leave a place knowing that what you did made a difference, even in one person's life, is really the most important thing you can leave a place with. So to know that your life had an impact on somebody else's for the better, and that you were able to do something and create something and leave something that makes people's lives better, there's nothing better than that. So I have been blessed and fortunate and happy that I've gotten to do that for the last 17 years. I don't know what I'm gonna do next. I haven't decided yet. I do know I'm not gonna work for the rest of this year. Ha ha. I'm enjoying the walks on the beach in the morning. I'm enjoying, I make breakfast for my husband and my son every day. And I make lunch for him and bring it to him in his office where he's sitting right now. And I hang out with my girlfriend on the beach. I lay by the pool. These are good things. I like this. So it's definitely something I'm getting used to, but yes, I will wind up doing something else in the future, but I can't thank everybody here enough, for everything that you've done. You've been a part of my journey. And again, when I got here, who would have ever known I'd be leaving here legally married with a son? You know, when I got here, I mean, unthinkable. And here I am legally married and I have a child. So all of that happened here and it would never have happened if I wasn't here. So thank you, everybody. Thank you for all that you've done. Thank you to all of my team, because you're all incredible and you know that. And know that I'm only a phone call away, so I'm not that far away. And Florida, I know it seems like it's far and I know the politics are a little crazy, but where I live is nice. So please, you know, if you're ever in the Jacksonville area, I'm just a 40-minute ride away from the airport. So thank you all for coming. Thank you for all of the support. Thank you for this whole shindig. This has been wonderful. Thanks.
Thank you.
There's one other person I didn't actually talk about, and I have to talk about. Holy crap. And it is my boss.
Not you.
I'm teasing. No, it is. It's Beth. Oh my gosh, the person that is literally singularly responsible for me not being crazy. Come over here. Where are you? Come with me. This person is literally the reason through COVID and before that I am not in the nut house. And I say that quite literally. She talks about, you know, like the future. She's never made a mistake, first of all, of note in her life, but one of the things, and I'm looking at Adolfo because he can tell you, I get credit for the basic needs stuff and whatever. She's the one doing it. And it's Beth is, the incredible thing about Beth is if she doesn't know how to do something, she won't tell me she doesn't know how to do it. She'll go figure out and she'll take a class. She'll learn how to do it. And then she does it and she takes over. And you know, the basic needs folks, I'm leaving and we're going to transition that to somebody else. And they were like, but we have to keep her. And it was very funny because when you came, you didn't want to a job. You just wanted to do something for a couple of hours. And I really didn't want an assistant because I didn't like people managing me, because, you know, whatever. So we were like, kind of like thrown to, you didn't want to work and I didn't really want an assistant, but I knew I needed help. And I would have been completely useless the last 4 years without her. So to the people in this room with whom she still works, this is gold. So do not mess with gold.
Thank you.
Thank you, honey. Thank you for putting this up. Thank you so much. Okay. Now I'm done.
So again, thank you to Beth and to Karina and to Candace and to Michael and to Salpi and to Luis and their teams for helping make all of this possible, because it truly has been a team effort. And you see by the number of folks, Tom, who showed up today, that they care about you.
They do.
You know, in the words of Sally Fields, they love you. They really, really like you. And so we have one final thing. You cannot have a retirement party without what? A cake. So if you will, please. And
I'm afraid of what's on this cake.
And we can't just have cake, but we have to have
oh my God.
Tom cake.
Good Lord.
Holy crap. I never wore that princess hat.
So we will see who gets the knife first and where they start cutting. But
Honey, are you able to see this? Nilo, did you see the cake?
There's, yeah, so Michael's got his laptop there.
Oh, it's frightening.
Yeah.
That is something.
So with that, please continue to have food and drink that's still, you know, in the conference room and outside. Please hang around, say hi to Tom. Go to the photo booth. Luis, thank you for that. Have cake. Cutest baby of the day award goes to Fee Tovo's kid. And if you need any tips on fashion, see Benzar Menken. And thank you all for coming today.
shotgun home. Yeah, hailing sister, who's your Superman? Hailing sister, shotgun. It's a nice day to start again. It's a nice day for a white wedding. It's a nice day to start again. Ow. We'll be right back.